Hello students, welcome back in English grammar class. This is your teacher Miss Hafsa, and our today's topic is degrees of adjectives. As we have already discussed adjectives with its different types, you know adjectives are words that describes different nouns. Before going to degrees of adjectives, let's first discuss that how can adjectives be formed. Adjectives can be formed from different nouns. Main adjectives are formed from nouns. Like if we add something more to nouns, so we can form adjectives from them. Look at the examples. In first list, nouns are given, and in another list, different adjectives are given, which are made from the same nouns. Like from fool, we can make the word foolish. From dirt, we can make adjective dirty. Storm, stormy. Care, carefully. Careful. Hope, hopeful. Courage, courageous. Glory, glorious. Gold, golden. Gift, gifted. These are all adjectives which can be formed from these different nouns. And we have lot of more adjectives which are formed from nouns in the same way. Adjectives can be also formed from different verbs. Some adjectives are formed from verbs. Like look at the verbs on the right side. Tire. Tire. Tiresome. Tiresome is an adjective which is made from the verb tire. Seize. Ceaseless. Talk. Talkative. Move. Movable. So these are adjectives which are made from verbs, and we can form many different adjectives from different verbs in the same way. Adjectives can be also formed from different adjectives. Some adjectives are formed from other adjectives. Like look at the word tragic. Tragic itself is an adjective, but we can form tragical from it. Black, blackish. Whole, wholesome. White, whitish. Three, threefold. Sick, sickly. In this way, different adjectives can be formed from different adjectives as well. Let's come to the degrees of adjectives. You know what is degree? Degree mean a level, a quantity, a point, an extent. So let's discuss. The first one is positive degree. Positive degree of an adjective is the adjective in its simple form. Like when we just say any adjective, so it would be in its positive degree. Like it just tell us the quality of something. It is used to denote the mere existence of some quality of what we speak about. Like if we are discussing a noun, we are saying something a noun, and we use some words to describe it. Like if I tell you that you are a good girl or you are strong, so this is just I'm discussing one person or one thing. It is used when no comparison is made. We are not comparing anything or anyone to anything other or anyone else. So in this way, it is the positive degree, because no comparison is made in it, and we are just discussing something related to some nouns. Look at the examples. She is a good girl. I am strong. Then we have another degree, comparative degree. The comparative degree of an adjective denotes a higher degree of the quality than the positive. Like from the positive, it is a little bit upper degree or upper point, upper level, and is used when two things or sets of things are compared. When we are comparing two things or two different sets of things, so we use comparative degree between them. Like if we look at the examples, this boy is stronger than that. Here we are comparing two boys, that this one is more stronger than that. So here the word stronger shows us that there is a comparison between two things. And usually the word than is also used in comparative degree, because we are comparing two things, so we use the word than. Which of these two pens is the better? Here the word better is comparative degree, because it is telling us that in between these two pens, which one is better. Let's discuss another one. We have superlative degree. The superlative degree of an adjective denotes the highest degree of the quality. It shows us the peak point, the highest point, the highest level, and is used when more than two things or sets of things are compared. When we compare more than two things or more than two sets of different things, so we use superlative degree in it. This boy is the strongest in the class. Here one boy is compared with the whole class, all the students of the class, that this one is the strongest. So here the word strongest is superlative degree. She is the most beautiful bride of all. Here one bride is compared with the rest of many brides. So the word most beautiful is superlative degree here. I am the tallest girl of my class. So here again the girl is compared with the whole class, that someone is saying that I am the tallest girl. Have you noticed one thing? We use the article the with the superlative degrees. Like, as you can see, the strongest, the most beautiful, the tallest. So we use the article the with superlative degree. Then we have another type of degree. Like, it's not the main type, but we discuss it, absolute degree. Adjectives that cannot take comparative or superlative degree is called absolute adjectives. We have certain adjectives which didn't take the comparative or superlative degree, like which have no comparative and superlative degree. They cannot be graded. We cannot give them any grade, any level. Also known as an incomparable. Incomparable mean like it cannot be compared with anything. Or ultimate modifier. Ultimate modifier, we can call them ultimate modifier as well. Absolute adjectives are always in the superlative degree. They are always in superlative degree, that's why we didn't make any comparison of it. Look at the examples. Did, asleep, unique, impossible, complete, final, perfect, round. Like, we cannot say that he is the more did person or he is the most did person, because if someone die, they just completely die. So we just say that this person is dead. Same asleep, if someone asleep, we just say that he is asleep. We cannot say that he is more asleep or he is most asleep. So that's why it is called absolute degree, which have no comparison. Same unique, if something is unique, if something is impossible, or if something is complete. So we just say that this thing is complete. We didn't make any comparison of it. Final, perfect, and round. Like, we cannot say that this thing is more round than that one. Okay, then look at the topic, formation of comparative and superlative degree. How we form comparative and superlative? Such degrees can be formed from the positive degree, and they can also be called regular degree, because the word the positive word is regularly repeated in comparative and superlative degree. Look at it. Most adjectives of one syllable. You know one syllable? Some words are one syllable, some have two syllables, some have more than two syllables. Syllables are the vowel sounds in a word, and some of more than one. Some words are of more than one. Form the comparative by adding ER and the superlative by adding EST to the positive. Like, one syllable words are made from positive degree by adding ER or EST with it. With comparative, we add ER. With the superlative, we add EST. Look at it. Like, positive degree is sweet. So the word sweeter is made from it. Then sweetest is the superlative degree of sweet. Small, smaller, smallest. Bold, bolder, boldest. Clever, cleverer, cleverest. Kind, kinder, kindest. Young, younger, youngest. Great, greater, greatest. These are all regular degree. Why? Because if you noticed it, the positive degree are repeated in comparative and superlative degrees. And we just add ER with comparative degrees and EST with superlative degrees. And they are almost monosyllable or one syllable words, and some are more than one syllable words. Then we have adjectives of more than two syllables form the comparative and superlative by putting more and most before the positive. Like, when we have two syllable words or more than two syllable words, then we added more or most before the positive degree. Like, beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. It is two syllable word, like beautiful. So we add more and most with it. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Difficult, It is two syllable word. So more difficult, most difficult. Skillful. Skillful is also a two syllable word, like skill and full. So we would add just more and most with it. Skillful, more skillful, most skillful. And it is also regular degree of adverb, because the positive degree is repeated in comparative and superlative. Some adjectives are called irregular. The following adjectives are compared irregularly, that is, their comparative and superlative are not formed from their positive degree. Like, their comparative and superlative are not formed from the positive degree. It means that positive degree is not repeated in comparative and superlative. We added some new words, or we just use some new word for comparative and superlative. If you just look at it, good, so its comparative degree is well or better, and superlative degree is best. It would not be like this, that good, gooder, goodest. No, it's completely changed. That's why it is called irregular degree. Good, better, best, bad, worse, worst, little, less, least, much more, most. So these were all about adjectives. Hope this lecture would be clear to you. Your homework for today is that you have to write 10 adjectives, and then you would make its comparative and superlative degrees. Hope you have learned a lot. Have a nice day. See you then.